Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Morphology of Flowering Plants. In that, we are studying topic Structure of Xylem. Xylem is a conducting vessel in plant. It helps to carry water and minerals. So what is the structure of xylem and how does it conduct water and minerals? Today, we'll be studying that. Xylem. Now, inside plants, xylem is present everywhere. It is the conducting vessel, or you can say the pipeline of a plant. Xylem is basically a continuous vessel that is starting from the roots of the plant up to the leaves. It conducts water, minerals from the soil or absorb water minerals from the soil and distribute to different plant parts or organs. Xylem basically consists of four different types of cells, or you can say four different parts. One of them is trachea, vessel, fibers and parenchyma cell. All this together help xylem in conduction of minerals and water. First, let's come to parenchyma cells. Now, parenchyma cells are nothing but simple permanent tissues, a part of meristematic tissues. They are basically in xylem thin walled cells made up of cellulose, and they're responsible to store certain materials, minerals basically, for xylem conduction. Vessels are nothing but rows of cell plates placed upon one another for better conduction or better movements of inorganic minerals like magnesium, calcium and all such. Tracheids. Tracheids, basically when they form, they are alive. But once they are mature, they are dead at maturity. They provide mechanical support to the xylem when it is conducting minerals from lower layer of soil to the higher layers, that is to the leaves, or you can say the thylakoid of the leaves. The cells of tracheids are basically spindle-shaped cells. Xylem, the conducting vessel of the plant. It is basically a continuous vessel that starts from the roots, basically the primary root, or you can say the secondary or tertiary root, till the leaf of the plant, where actually plant food is prepared. Basically, the whole plant structure consists of xylem vessels. The main function of xylem vessels are to conduct water and minerals from the soil to different parts of the plant, and more importantly to the leaf, where plant food is basically made. Xylem is made up of four different types of cells: tracheids, vessels, fibers and parenchyma cells. Now among this, parenchyma cells are basically thin-walled, living, and they are made up of material called as cellulose. All the wood, the basic component of wood is cellulose, from which paper is made. The main function of parenchyma is to store materials, basically ions when they are absorbed from soil. The another kind of cells present in xylem are fibers and tracheids. Now, fibers are basically scleromatous in nature. Basically, fibrous cells of xylem consist certain features of sclerenchyma. They are long, elongated, certain types, and most importantly, they are dead. In primary and secondary xylem, that is in the thick regions of the plant, the walls need to be thick, especially the stem region or the thicker branches. There, fibers of xylem which are dead are mostly present in larger number. Lastly, tracheids. Now, tracheids along with vessels, they work together. Tracheids are basically providing mechanical support to the plant. Whenever conduction of water in midlands is done and there is storm or the weather conditions are not good, that time tracheids help to transport minerals in proper proportion and in proper way, especially during droughts. Now, tracheid cells are dead at maturity. They don't divide further at maturity. That is one striking feature of tracheid cells. Besides this, they are spindle in shape. Students, in this part of the chapter, we have studied about the structure of xylem and the four different components of xylem and their function. Now, this diagram represents the structure of xylem. We all know that xylem basically consists of four different parts. There are certain regions in xylem that helps in the conduction of minerals and water. The xylem vessel, or you can say vessel members. Inside this, if you see, this structure represents a xylem, and these fibers or tracheids are present inside this structure. The perforations. Perforations are nothing but openings or plates which are present at the outer region of xylem. And these perforation plates help to absorb nutrients, minerals, that is calcium, magnesium, by the process of diffusion in the case of gases, or by the process of osmosis, that is movement from higher concentration to lower concentration inside xylem. Whereas the vessels, or you can say xylem member vessels, are the ones that help to absorb individual minerals, that is calcium, magnesium, ions. These are xylem tracheids and fibers. Now, they basically inside xylem help to move xylem in the rigid part of the plant, or you can say they provide mechanical support to the plant. Students, this is how two different parts of xylem come together and help the xylem plant in better manner. Thank you.